Ke a dumedisa ka leina le lebotse la Morena Jesu ke re dumelang le amogelegile ka Ramogadi Channel. Re nna ba maoto o dule gausi o ba tamele gobane ditaba tsona ke tse dintšhi jalo ka metlha. Mogadi Channel e tlile le tsona e tle go tsholela tsona di santšhane di fiša di tswa pitšeng di tswa go beng ba tsona. Mme re na le moporofeta Zukiswa jalo ka metlha. Zukiswa o tlile ka ditaba tse dikgolo tse di nyakang tsebe ya gago. Ba tamela o le ngwana Modimo o tlo kwa ditaba tse. O re na Modimo o reng ka nakong ya gona jwale, Modimo o reng ka setšhaba sa gage, Modimo o reng ka bophelo ka kakaretso. Mamotlhale re kwa a tshwere taba e kgolo ya kwa KwaZulu-Natal e e bolelang ka tse di tlo ba diragalelang kwa KwaZulu-Natal ka lebaka la go kgeloga tseleng ya Modimo, ka baka la go itirela medingwana, ka lebaka la go rapela le tsona dimametsi gomme ba fetola dinoka. Batamela o tlo mokwe ga di bolelela tse dintšhintšhi gore na go tlo diragalang ka mafula. Ka matamo a e leng gore a tlo cracker goba matamo a e leng gore a tlo bulega wa tseba metsi a ya bathong batho ba tlo gogola ke metsi ka mokgwa mang. Ke ditaba tse dikgolo kudu wa tseba keng tse nyakang tsebe e tlhoko tsebe e leng gore e ya theletša ebile e ya theletša gomme re kgona go kwa ge Modimo a bolela. Batamela o tlo ba gausi gobane ke tse dintšhi di tlhoka wena kudu go dula gona kwa KZN gore o kgone go tseba go iprepare o kgone go tseba gore na ke efe tsela e o tshwanetseng o e tšee. Gomme re kwa le ka wona mmušo wa ANC gore ka 2029 o tla ba o feletswe ke maatla gomme o ka tlhatlhola o buša. Re tlo dikwa ka moka ka tsona ge di tla ka monga tsona gobane wa tseba ke eng ka Ramogadi Channel ga ditaba di le gona. Re dumelele monga tsona e be yena a di tlišang ka sebele gomme a re tsholele tsona gobane yena ke ena morumiwa wa ditaba tse. Gomme nna le wena re lo ba batheletše gomme re tšea maele gomme ra tseba go phunyoga. A re tlo mofatse be re tlo mokwa ge Zukiswa a tlo di bia ditaba tse molemong wa ka le wena gore nna le wena re kgone go phunyoga. O se ka lebala go subscribe go le moso ka ralenaneo le gore ditaba tse ge di tsena ka mokgwa e leng tse botlhokwa ka gona di seke tšaba tša leka tša go feta. Gomme re fele maikutlo a gago ka comment section gomme o se ka lebala le o arolela ba bangwe share button e gona. Gomelela le metswalle le ba gageno gore le bona ba kgone go kgolega ditabeng tša mohuta oo. A re thetsene.
Hello everyone, I hope you're well. My name is Zukiswa. I am the prophet. I'm the prophet before God. Yeah. A servant of the Lord Jesus Christ, born again, baptized and Holy Spirit filled and commissioned to be the prophetic voice of God to the house of Ham, of which is the black and brown people. I hope you are well. The Africans and Indian nationals, wherever they may be in the world. Today I'm bringing the word of the Lord that the Lord gave me on the 21st of August 2024. It is entitled The Trouble from the North, Part 1. Our banner scriptures, it comes from Ezekiel 34, Woe Judgments, the Lord says, and then Jeremiah 4, verse 5 to 6. The ANC will fall. They won't make it to the next elections. By 2029, local elections, provinces will govern themselves according to the tribes. KZN Zulus, there will be too little left of them and their land will decrease in habitable places. There won't be anyone in the northern KZN. From Ulundi upwards, the land will be uninhabitable before the famine. The famine will be in 2030, from 2030 to 2037. So the Lord says even before that, there will be nobody. By the time the famine begins in 2030 to 2031, there won't be anyone living in the north of KZN. The survivors of the war and natural disasters will make it down south towards South Coast. Part Hluhluwe towards the south only will be habitable. So this is saying that Hluhluwe will be cut or divided into two. The southern parts of Hluhluwe will survive, the northern parts will not be habitable. Saint Lucia will be underwater. The Lord says it will go underwater. That place is where they meet with mermaids. This thing about mermaids, guys, those things are wicked. When you are, we are in the land, in Africa, are already troubled by the marine spirit, marine kingdom. Now you are taking the marine kingdom into your counsel, into your confidence. Why are we doing that? Today is, the date today is the 27th of August, 2024. Last week, sometime around the 15th, I discovered that some guy came on my TikTok and told me about, have you heard about what's happening in Umsing and the mermaid? And I never really paid attention at that time because I was very busy. But then last week sometime, as I am, thank you, Lord, as I was scrolling through, checking my Facebook, this thing comes up. And I go and check it on YouTube. It is so. You who have housed the wicked spirit in Umsing, you will live to pay for it with your children's blood. Those things consume blood. They are there for tyranny. They are here because their habitat or their territory underwater either has been seized or is about to be seized by the Leviathan. So the Lord says in St. Lucia, that's where they meet with these mermaids. Josini Dam walls will fall on the surrounding residents. People need to start moving away from the bridge. The bridge will break into two and there will be no money to fix it. No, it won't be because of rain or flash floods, but structural fault. So they will say, the river was diverted to make a way for men's development. There was certain disgust in the Lord's voice when he said, for men's development. And where the people settled is where the river used to run. It'll simply redirect itself back to its origin in broad daylight, but the people won't be able to run fast enough from the water. This got me really thinking this morning as I was preparing this word of God, that if you are angry when a visitor in your house changes the dining, the sitting room sofas, you come back home, the table with the chairs, the dining table is no longer in its place, you are angry. You come back home, somebody changed the direction in which your bed is facing without telling you, you are angry. Jay, you come to your car, somebody has adjusted the seat belt, the seat. Somebody has adjusted the seat. You are angry. Imagine you who are doing this thing of diverting the rivers and the nature of God, because you refuse to live and accept the will and the sovereignty of God. You want God to live around you, to find himself and fit himself around your sovereignty, when your sovereignty came from his sovereignty. I know what's more wicked. You, as women, you arrange your clothes in your wardrobe in a certain direction. They face the hangers are facing a certain direction. Your outfits are put in that wardrobe. When you fold the washing, you purpose. And now you're going for a certain outfit, has been changed. I get mad when my hangers are facing each other direction and it's a mess. My morning is ruined. Imagine God, for centuries, people in KZN, you've been doing this thing of diverting the rivers. They're already saying those rivers will simply redirect themselves. In the broad daylight, everybody watching, they will simply redirect themselves. They will break away exactly where you started diverting them. And they'll go where the Lord, the owner of the universe, the owner of the house, put them. They'll simply move themselves back to its origin where I put it with all its might. Imagine those waters. Homes will be buried forever, and some people will be buried there, and therefore no funerals for them. They'll simply be identified by their items they were wearing when the bridge or river went into the people's houses. They also said there's a lot of these rivers in KZN that were diverted to feed the development of men. If you live, if there's any river by the area where you are living, start Googling and check if your river was not diverted. Because if you have a residence that surround itself by the river that was redirected and diverted against you, so that development of the house you live in can exist, the river will simply direct itself back to your house. God says there will be no funeral for you. You will simply be underwater forever. Some things are just not necessary. This is one of those things that were never necessary. What is natural then? Do you understand the levels at which this thing is at? What will remain natural if you are even directing the river? We are taking seeds from the sea, by the seashore, and go and plant it in inland. We are taking the seeds from inland, go to the lab, fix them up so they can feed the inland. And then we wonder why the weather is upside down. What remains natural to us, guys? What is our baseline, or what is our line or benchmark? Where did we draw that line that says this one is natural then? If you are diverting the rivers. If the rivers are not the rivers, we diverted the flow of the river. We're trying to be God. We don't need to know what were the reasons why the Lord decided to put the river there. Now we're going to redirect it. He must go take it elsewhere, but it remains his planet. He created it. I don't own planet Earth, but if you come to my house and you visit, we make a decision that you come live in my house. I give you shelter in my house. Now you are redirecting, you are changing the furniture. There's going to be misunderstandings. I know why I put that chair there. I enjoy sitting in that chair in that corner. I know why I put it there. You're coming into my house and you're painting walls. It is my house. You are a visitor. All their occultic ways will catch up with them, because I will get all my people and simply move them out of the way, harm's way, and I will let the stubborn reap the rewards of their works of iniquity. I am their God, meaning I'm the God of the ones that I will take out of the harm's way, and the stubborn ones, their God they listen to. Or will they listen to? Meaning the stubborn ones are stubborn towards me because they are listening to another God. The ones that I will save listen to me because I am their God. Do you understand? All those of you who are saying there's only one God. There's other gods, guys, that you are worshipping. In KZN, there's other gods. And if you're worshipping those other gods, you will listen to them to death. Twice. Then they will remember me, and I will not hear them anymore. The Lord says, he will not hear you anymore. He will choose not to hear you anymore. He will decide not to hear you anymore. All of you stubborn ones who are worshipping the other gods, when the other gods betray you and now they want to eat you and you, they have marked you for destruction and calamity, and you come back to the Lord. The Lord says, I will simply not hear them. My choice. When I called out for them, they were not home, the Lord says. This is a scripture in Isaiah. They were at the field of Nomkhubulwana. You know, guys, there's lots of deception and lies in South Africa. There's lots of lies and deception in South Africa. I was, was 2 years ago when I discovered that Nomkhubulwana is Oshan. That wicked woman from Nigeria, that Yoruba people are worshipping in Nigeria. Nomkhubulwana is the queen of the coast or the queen of heaven from the book of Jeremiah. In South Africa, this lady, this wicked lady, this wicked spirit that eats the blood of the babies, this thing has the whole field that there's a, there's villages who go to, who go and cultivate this field. And there they learn the best insult. They learn the best spells. They learn the best levels of witchcraft with your mouth. Their mouths are that field is where they learn the filthy mouth. There's nobody who has a filthy mouth like Zulus because they go to that field of Nomkhubulwana. I was shocked when this was a woman fighting with another woman on TikTok age, talking about this thing. They were arguing about who is more divine, who is more powerful when it comes to divine. And this other one was saying, I was at the field of Nomkhubulwana. So meaning that that field is the highest level in the divination place or the darkness. This is this one who, when he wants, she wants worship and it's not happening, she will thresh people's millies. There will be the hailstorms when she's angry, this one. She will wait for you to cultivate. When her field is not cultivated, she will then cause the hailstorms that will destroy other people's crops. I don't know what's more wicked. Until they pay her the money and a sangoma goes and sing, and that field must be cultivated and planted. I know what's more wicked. Southern Africans, Zulu people, you're wicked. And the Lord has judged you for it. I'm just going to read out everything that the Lord tells me about you. I feel hurt to say you deserve it. But when the Lord began this thing with me, with the Shembe people, I thought God is being God. The thing about me is that I believe God for every word that he says. Even the things that are, that one seems so outfetched when the Lord said, I'm closing the gate for these ones, for forgiveness. These ones will never receive I'm closing the repentance gate on them. I thought, Lord, this is extreme. But I wrote it down and I thought in my mind, it is extreme. But now that the Lord is bringing out all the files, yay! That's all I can say. Whoa, I can say. When I called out for them, they were at this field of Nomkhubulwana, the field of the Queen of the Coast, cultivating for the Queen of the Coast, the spirit, the wicked spirit that eats their children's blood, as a token of appreciation for eating their babies from 0 to 2 years. They have to cultivate. These are women. This spirit specializes on being worshipped by women. This is a spirit of gender bending. That this spirit jacks up men. They become the quiet Ahabs and women becomes the masculine. Men become submissive under the spirit and women love the men. And chaos ensues from there. The sanctuary of God, of which is the home where the woman and the baby stays, it becomes strifey because of this spirit. But then, as an extra, the Zulu people must go to the field and cultivate food, put grain in there, go back and hoe it, while they're learning the foul tongue, the vile tongue that comes out of the Zulu women. I don't know what's worse, men or women, I don't know, but the tongue of those people, when they unleash their tongue, you know that they've been, I learned a thing that day, 2 years ago, on TikTok. I learned a thing that, okay, the reason why the Zulus are extremely mouthy and vile when it comes to the mouth. There's no, you know, the type of insults that will get you to suicide. The Zulus got those. Because they go into that field, that wicked field. When I called out for them, meaning I'm looking for my people, even the stubborn ones. These ones, they were not home, so nobody answered. They were at the field of Nomkubulwan. Number two, they were at the ceremony of the ancestors. Number three, they were at the initiation school for the ancestral graduation, meaning somebody is now a divine. Witchcraft. Witchcraft with a certificate. You are so wicked that you graduated in witchcraft. You no longer just a witch flying on the broom. No. Now you get to initiate other people into them. You need to teach other people how to get their brooms, how to fix their brooms. That's what is Inyanga, Izangoma. All those witches, warlocks, and wizards, same thing. There's no witch doctor. It's a witch. It's a wizard. It's a native witch. It's a traditional witch. It's a traditional wizard. It is not a traditional doctor. No. You don't get to cut the roots for being the doctor. It's all sorcery. It's just like a chemist. It is all sorcery. Wickedness. Read, dance. That thing is wicked. Stop going to that thing. Have nothing to do with that reality of KZN. That thing is a god. Shaga was the god who inserted himself as a king of kings to the KZN, to the Zulu people. And they be out there going, Bayete. You cannot say hail to the king, to the king of the kings of the universe, of the whole earth and heaven, and then come back and give the same praises to the same dude who's sitting there and wearing the 666 beast clothing, covering, whatever you call it. That whole tiger you are wearing, it is a 666 beast. Shaga came with one world order that got trampled on and got rid of quick and soon. I don't understand how we as the Zulus today are the typical tradition of Zulus is that, yes, they are wrong for marrying many wives, but most the typical tradition and the average man in Zulu kingdom or Zulu tribe or Zulu people is that they portray themselves as family people. Where is Shaga's wife? Why are we celebrating that vagabond? Why are we celebrating that son of a Satan? Why are we celebrating him? That son of a Satan opened, took a spear and opened women's stomach and took the children out because he did not want to have an heir. Who said we should celebrate him? Because that's the person we should go to. That thing, that whole monarch, whatever you call it, that whole kingdom, that whole royal house, whatever, it needs to be scrapped away, done away with. It is evil and wicked before God. It is not only wicked and wicked before God, it is wicked to the humankind as well, to the Zulus. There will never be peace in KZN. God has judged you for the same thing, that every time you bow down to that man and you say, Bayete, you must know that you're being idolatrous. It's a sin to say that. You cannot ascribe the same praises to the men and then the same praises to God. We don't tell men you are a king of kings, but Shaga was the king of kings and the Zulu people believe in that thing. That nigga died with no one. That thing called Shaga Zulu has no respect. He had no respect for human life. no respect for human life whatsoever. He built the second floor where he would just stand and look at a person and say, kill him. There was no wisdom in that dude. I don't understand. I have since that thing was on TV in the 90s when I was growing, I hated that thing. I've always hated that thing. I never knew why. Thank to the Lord now that I know that the rise and the fall of the Zulus will be with that Shaka line. You can come out of it, call on the Lord, and stop. Stop saluting that thing. There's no royal house. All of black people are the kings before God, according to their clans and their family names. Every clan name, every clan in KZN once had their king. They once had their king and their chiefs and their headsmen and all their leadership house. Until Shaka came and dismantled and became the leadership of the leadership, the leader of the leaders. Where is God? We have lost God, sight of God as a Zulu since 1800s. That cursed son. Don't deserve the kind of pedestal we're putting him in. Can't you see? I want to know, in which African tribe, you know, where they honor an unmarried man? Which culture, or which African tribe honors an unmarried man? Because in mine, of which is Zulu / Xhosa, we don't have a pedestal for a man who's not married. There's no honor for a man who's not married. There's no honor for a man who's a single man is just a boy. It's just a young boy. He becomes a man the day he gets married. Shaka died just. It is so bad that the funerals are, when we are burying people, guys, here in Southern Africa, in South Africa, when we're burying a person, if you died without a child and without a wife, you get buried at 9 o'clock, 11 o'clock in the morning, nobody cares. But if you are a man or a woman who was married and had a family, you get buried after 2 o'clock in the afternoon. It is an honorable thing. Everybody knows this thing. I don't know where it came from, but everybody knows this thing. KZN people, Zulus, come out of this Kool-Aid. It is death everywhere. And for all those of you in Southern Africa, I want to talk about something. Do you know that rain tradition? There's a tradition in Southern Africa where if we've already planted the seed, the rain is not coming. When the dry season suddenly comes after we planted the seed, when it's supposed to be a rainy season, but the rain don't come, we have a tradition where we put oil in our bodies, like you must be shiny. And then we bring our traditional outfits. And then we show up on the mountain. We will go there. People told me that we go there to pray to God for rain. It used to be a beautiful thing. I would be like, wow, we are so godly. We're praying to God for rain. Imagine a village somewhere that does that. We believe in that thing so much that you must wear light things or bring a raincoat if you have, so that, but because we know that when we come down from that mountain, we will be coming with the rain, that kind of thing. So you must wear a light clothes that you can run with. And I grow and I learn that no, the people who used to take that drum and go drum on top of the mountain, they are worshipping this evil, wicked queen of the heaven, queen of the coast, / Nomkhubulwane. It is an evil, wicked thing to pray to a spirit when the father of all souls, not all spirits, is looking at you and wondering what's going on. It is that Nomkhubulwane. It is that queen of the coast. He will shut down the rain and then make sure that you come and worship at her feet for rain. What kind of tyranny and wickedness don't you see this thing is? It is wicked to go and pray for rain to that woman. If you must, people would even put on their uniform of the churches when we go and do this thing. I was young, very young, when this thing used to be normal. And I never knew that we are worshiping other gods there. I thought you are made to believe that we are worshiping and praying to God, and therefore God brings. No, we are worshiping to the small gods. One of them that specializes in this tyranny of shutting down the rain in your crop season so that you will lose all your crop if you don't worship me is this thing, deity called Nomkhubulwane. This yellow-dressed woman that Beyonce and all these people with yellow dresses wear. If you ever feel the need to wear a yellow dress, you must know that you are a human sacrifice. You have just offered yourself up in the altars of darkness to be killed. You will die. Google all the people who have ever worn dresses. Sooner or later, they died. Whether they had a kind of disease or whether they are aware or unaware, anything yellow is a sacrifice in the kingdom of darkness. I'm still waiting on the Lord to break it down for me. But I will tell you, God hates it for you to wear yellow. The minute you put yellow dye in your head, you have put your head into the price stand. Excuse me, of Satan. You have just become a barbecue for Satan. Satan decides what happens to your head. So the Lord says, I was here the whole day calling for them. They were not there. So nobody answered. They were in the field of Nomkhubulwane learning how to have a filthy mouth, the Zulus. And then they were at the ceremony with their ancestors. And then they were in the initiation school, in the graduation of one of the ancestral calling with diviners. And then they were at the reed dance. They are not checking your daughters for the goodness of your daughters. Your daughters are being sacrificed. There's altars in the royal house of Zulus that eat these children. They are being taught anal sex in there. They are being taught ukusoma or ukusonya, how to have sex in your thighs in there. Your children are being passed through so much. Human sacrifice is happening there. It says in Mozambique, they are in Mozambique to consult the whistle powerful gods and the healers in all the desolate places that have not known peace, but are powerful in darkness and wickedness. The Lord is saying, I don't get it. If you live, for instance, South Africa, Zulus, and you go and get the powerful gods in Mozambique, the poorest, poorer than you, has powerful gods. Their land is desolate. Swaziland is desolate because they have these healers. But you go and get healed by the desolate people. Desolate people. The Lord says, I don't get it. And they don't get it. They themselves. No correlation as to why these places got powerful spirits but poor and barren land. They were saying, when is my people going to think that I can't have a powerful spirit in a barren land? Destruction, tumult is coming from the north to all those who hate God but in his planet, live in his planet Earth. Earth is for my sons, the Father says. Lord God who founded it upon the seas, says the Lord God who founded it upon the seas and established it upon the waters alone. Those who want to dwell in the earth must submit to him and him alone. This is when you know the Father, Father Yah is speaking. When the King of Kings, I am that I am, starts speaking and lays a few lines that are too strong for you, you must know you have touched a nerve that you shouldn't have. When the Father starts saying,
ke ya tshepa le go dumela gore o tloga o dikwele gomme o tloga o bulegile matlho ebile o ithutile gobane ke morero golwananeo le gore nna lona re ithute gomme re ya kwa gore ditaba tse di tla direga pele go 2030 pele go famine pele ka nako ya tlala ge itlo wela lefase tse ditaba di diregile gomme ge o le kgauso go le sebakeng seo o tla tseba gore na o tshwanetse o die jwang nako e santšaneng e le gona gomme re a leboga ka moporofeta re a leboga ka ditaba tse re a leboga ka kutullo modimo yo mo botse re ya go leboga a re boele re kopana gape ka ralanao le ka rong ga ditšhanele mo re tlo ithutang gona tse dintšhintšhi le rile o se ka ba wa shuta gobane ka mo ke legaeng la thuto re tlo ithuta gomme re tlo bulega matlho mme yena jesu e santšane e le morena re a leboga a re boele re kopana gape nakong ya latelang ke re tadang.